Bam! Mr. Tarrou.
Okay, we got the basics down, I hope. You understand from the first video. And let's just get to this unit circle so you can see what the final product is going to look like. Now, I keep saying unit circle, and all that is a circle whose center is on the origin. All of our angles are in standard position. Vertex is on the origin. And the radius is 1. That's the big deal. Unit circle, radius is 1. So, whoop-de-doo, right? Now, what that means is that I've got all these trig functions set up here. Sine is y over r, cosine is x over r, and tangent, which I'm not going to put on the unit circle as a value to memorize, is y over r. And I also said that the unit circle is mostly comprised of values that come off of these two triangles, the 60-30 triangle you learned from geometry, and the 45-45 triangle. Now, because of this definition of the unit circle has a radius of 1, some really cool things happen. Now you do want to definitely remember that sine is y over r, but for a unit circle only, the r value is going to always be 1. That's what the definition says. The radius is 1. So when you look at sine as y over r, at least as far as the unit circle is concerned, that's y over 1, or just the y value. So the sine is the y coordinate of all the points that we're going to have in a minute around the unit circle. For a unit circle whose radius is 1, the cosine is going to be x over 1. So as you look at all these points that we'll have done here in a minute around the unit circle, your cosine values are just simply the x coordinate. The x coordinate on a circle whose radius is 1 and the center is in the origin or on the origin of the coordinate plane, the xy coordinate plane. Now, I'm also going to be referring to these two specialty triangles from geometry, but the hypotenuse of a right triangle will act as the radius of the circle. So we want these radius values, these hypotenuse values, to be 1. So I'm going to come through here and effectively just divide all of these values by 2. So if I divide the value of 2 by 2, I get 1. And then if I divide this length by 2, I get 1/2. And if I divide this length by 2, I get square root of 3 over 2. I don't particularly prefer this ratio or these sides for a 60-30 triangle if I'm just using regular geometry and I'm just dealing with triangles that are around, you know, just sort of floating around in space. But for purposes of setting up the unit circle, I want the hypotenuse to be 1. And so I want this hypotenuse to also be 1. I'm just changing the size of these triangles. And so I'm going to do that by dividing everything by the square root of 2 to get all these lengths, or to get the hypotenuse, excuse me, into that length of 1 so I can place it as a radius of my unit circle. So square root of 2 divided by square root of 2 is 1. 1 divided by square root of 2, when you rationalize the denominator, is going to be the value of square root of 2 over 2. And then same thing, because the two legs of a 45-45 triangle are equal, it's also going to be the square root of 2 over 2. Now, there's 16 units angles around a unit circle. I know I just did this in an earlier video, so I'll go quickly with this. You count by 30. And count off your 12 of your 16 angles, so 30 degrees, 60 degrees, 90 degrees, 120, 150, 180, 210, 240, 270, 300 degrees, and then finally 330 degrees. Then for the other four angles on the unit circle, you want to count by 45. So 45, 135, 180, 225, 270, 315, and then finally, of course, either 0 or 360 degrees. Now, I went much slower in my original video for setting up the unit circle. 180 divided by 30, you have to divide by 6. Now 180 is equal to pi radians, so this is going to be equal to pi over 6. Pi over 3, I'm counting by 1/6, but I want to show you how to build up the coordinates, not the value, so I'm going to just give these out. 1/6, pi over 3, pi over 2, 2 pi over 3, 5 pi over 6, 7 pi over 6, 1, 2, 3, 4 pi over 3, 3 pi over 2, or 5 pi over 3. See, even I count these out and I teach this for a living. And 11 pi over 6. And then you count by pi over 4. So 1 fourth pi over 2, 3 pi over 4, pi, 5 pi over 4, 3 pi over 2, or 6 pi over 4, and then finally 7 pi over 4. Okay. Again, these degrees and these 16 degrees and these 16 radian measures must be memorized eventually to quicken your pace of your work, to make your work more efficient, and if you're one of my students, to pass all the unit circle quizzes I'm going to hit you with. Okay, now, let's keep in mind that on the unit circle, cosine is x over r, yes, and you do want to memorize that ratio of x over r, but on the unit circle, the radius is 1. So to simplify that, on the unit circle, the cosine is simply the x coordinate that we're going to get around these 16 points. The y is the sine of theta is y over r, and on the unit circle, the radius is always 1, so on the unit circle only, the sine value is simply going to be the y-coordinate of the point. So we have a circle whose radius is equal to 1. So as you remember that as we go around this. So now what's the coordinate this point at 0? That coordinate is 1, 0. So the cosine of, theta is your first number. So the cosine of 0 is going to be 1. And the sine of theta is going to be, again, the y-coordinate. Cosine is the x-coordinate, and the sine is the y-coordinate. So at 0, the cosine of 0 is 1, and the sine of 0 is equal to 0. Now at 30 degrees, let's go ahead and set up that triangle with 30 here, and we have square root of 3 over 2, 1 half, and 1. So the cosine of 30 is x over r, so the cosine of 30 is square root of 3 over 2. And the y value at 30 degrees, when you rotate 30 degrees, the y coordinate of that point, or the sine of 30, is y over r, just simply 1 half. Okay, and I'll do a 45 degree angle up here for 135. But let's just fill it in for now. At 45 degrees, and you can look here, at 45 degrees, the x and the y coordinate is square root of 2 over 2. And the same for the y coordinate, square root of 2 over 2. At 60 degrees, now again, I'm going to do a triangle, a reference triangle in each quadrant, but I can't keep drawing it over this one, you won't be able to read it. So at 60 degrees, the cosine value is going to be, I kind of want to just, you know, sort of like put my finger on it, 0 to 30, that's 60 degrees, and opposite 60 degrees you have, or adjacent to 60 degrees, you have 1 half. So the cosine of 60 is 1 half, and the y coordinate is square root of 3 over 2. It's kind of bugging me that I'm not drawing that, so let's go ahead and do that. Feel like you might need to see that, even though I was going to do it in another quadrant. There. So at 60 degrees, when I draw my reference triangle with the 60 here and the right angle, adjacent to 60, you have a length of 1 half, an x coordinate of 1 half, and a y coordinate opposite 60, you have that length of square root of 3 over 2. And again, for unit circle purposes, the radius or the hypotenuse, I'd prefer to have that set at 1. So the cosine of 60 is x over 1, or 1 half, and the sine of 60 is square root of 3 over 2, and we see that right there. And at 90 degrees, we can't set up a triangle because we're straight up and down in the x-axis. Acts as one of the legs of the triangle, so there's no way you can draw a triangle there. But we know that if we're at the origin and we simply go up one length, one unit, that coordinate is 0, 1. So the cosine of 90 is 0, and the sine of 90, the y-coordinate, we're up one unit, so the sine value is 1. Now let's go over here to 120 degrees. Well, I want to draw a triangle at 135, so I'm not going to draw this one, but at 120 degrees, the reference angle for 60 degrees is 60. The previous video I defined what reference angle was. If I rotate over to 120 degrees, I'm 60 degrees off of the x-axis. So this 120 and 60 degrees has the same 60 degree reference angle. Let me just draw a little tiny piece of that right there. Okay, so 120 and 60 degrees are going to have very familiar looking coordinates. Only when you're in quadrant 2, the x's are negative. So this will be negative 1 half and square root of 3 over 2. Now I will draw a proper triangle for 135 degrees. So let's do that. Pick a different color here. Say red. If we rotate over to 135 degrees, and there'd be an angle in a standard position angle here of 135 degrees, well, again, you can't make a right triangle out of an obtuse angle, but what you can do is make a right triangle as a reference triangle, right? We want to draw those against the x-axis, not the y-axis. And at 135 degrees, you're 45 degrees off of the x-axis. So there's a 45 degree reference angle here. Well, look at the sides we have. As you move to the left, your x's are negative. And as you go up, your y values are positive. And then the radius is going to be set at 1. So the cosine of 135 degrees is x over r, or negative square root of 2 over 2, and the y-coordinate is also square root of 2 over 2. Do you see how these coordinates are starting to match up? The only difference is, because I'm in quadrant 2, my x-coordinates are negative instead of positive like they were in quadrant 1. At 150 degrees, where I'm again 30 degrees off of the x-axis, this point will have the same coordinates as this point, except, of course, again, the x is going to be negative, so negative square root of 3 over 2, and positive 1 half. At pi, we're at negative 1, 0. At 210, we're at negative square root of 3 over 2 and negative 1 half. Now we're getting into a negative y value because, of course, we're moving down, and I'm running out of time, so we have a 30 degree reference angle, so these points are all going to have something in common, except my x's are negative and my y's are negative. And let me just give you the final answers here. Negative square root of 2 over 2, negative square root of 2 over 2, negative 1 half, negative square root of 3 over 2. Where'd the time go? 0, negative 1, 1 half, negative square root of 3 over 2. You should be noticing that these coordinates are starting to repeat because all the points that have very similar coordinates, except for a sign change, all have matching reference angles. So 30, 150, 210, and 330 all have a 30 degree reference angle, so they all have very similar coordinates. It's just with the sign change, and that pairing matches up all the way around that unit circle. I'm Mr. True. That's a unit circle. Bam! You will notice in the 30 seconds that I have left, 45, 135, 225, and 315, again, all have matching coordinates except for sine changes because they all have the same reference angle of 45 degrees. 60, 120, 240, and 300 as well as matching reference angles of 60 degrees, and therefore they have the same coordinates, only with sign changes. Thank you very much for listening and let me help. I'm Mr. True. Go do your homework.